ARIS Commander offers us many tools to work with custom blocks that are the smart blocks equivalent to dynamic blocks in AutoCAD. We are going to insert a custom block. Note that the insertion point is located as centered on the screw base. We insert it with one click. This custom block has the ability to vary its height, dragging from a grip located on its head. However, the point it offers does not fit the graphic references we have in the drawing. ARIS Commander offers us now the possibility of choosing among multiple insertion points when inserting the block. Let's make another insertion. Not only do we have the base point to be able to insert it, but by pressing the Control key, we can switch between more points. In this example, we see that we have three possible insertion points. But where do these points come from? How are they configured? The truth is that these cyclic insertion points are given by the different action points that the custom block may have configured. Let's take a closer look. In the block editor, we can easily find the insertion point, indicated in the video as 1. A second point that aims to change the height of the screw thread. And the third point which allows us to change the height of the screw. The base point cycle command allows us to select which points will be used as insertion points, taking into account that there are only 2 of them in the list, simply because the base point can't be removed and does not have therefore to be listed. We will select one of them and we will remove it by tapping on the cycling button. Now we only have the base point and this other point. Press OK. We close and save the changes. Now we're going to insert this block again. Press the Control key to vary between the different insertion points. Therefore, it might be convenient for us to create more intermediate actions to achieve more insertion points. In this case, in the block editor, we will add a point element. We choose one grip. In activities, we choose move. First, we select the element, that is the point that we have added. Then we must specify the entities that in this case will be all of them. Thus, using this point, we can move the block anywhere. Press enter. Now we're going to use the test block command of ARIS Commander. That allows us to test the block before returning to the drawing or to continue with new actions within the block editor. Select the test block command. Note that a new window opens for this test mode and we can try our custom block. For example, we move it using the new grip or we can change its height. Then we can close the test mode to return to the block editor. With the command base point cycle, we can see that the new point we have added appears. We check that it is active. If we wanted to remove it, just select it and press the cycling button. But in this case, we're interested in keeping it selected. Press OK. We close the block editor and save the changes in the block. We insert the block again. Press the Control key until you reach the new point, so we can insert it exactly where we want. Thanks to that, we have a new reference point for insertion. We can also vary the order in which the insertion points cycle. To do this, from the block editor, we go to the base point cycle command and change the position of the references. Select a point and press the move up button to upload it, or move down if we want to download it. This will be enough to change the order in which the insertion points will be displayed after touching the control key. Please take a look at our next video to learn more about the custom blocks and how they compare with dynamic blocks. You may also check the extensive help offered by the software.